Let us continue now with the BRS example. We have understood what is bank reconciliation statement and the reasons and how BRS to be prepared. The format we know, we are going to do all the example with the debit credit method, because as we learn the double entry system in which we have the debit and credit. So the format for the question is, you have the title bank reconciliation statement of whatever the party as on. It is a statement, so it is as on. The columns are serial number, particulars means the reason, whatever, then debit rupees and credit rupees. BRS questions start with any one of the book balance or overdraft, whatever is given as per example, and it always end with the another book balance or overdraft, whatever we find as a answer. So let us start with question number 5, page number 291 of your textbook. Cash book of the Naresh shows the credit balance of bank 12,000 as on 31st March 16. So we have to prepare the bank reconciliation statement of Naresh as on 31st March 16. Here it is given cash book credit balance, clear? So credit cash book of the Naresh shows the credit balance. Always cash book normally have the debit balance. Here it is given credit balance. So we have to start as the bank overdraft of cash book. So let us start with cash book credit balance. As given the information, write into the credit column rupees 12,000, which does not tally with the balance as per the passbook. Following are the information, we have to derive the balance as per the passbook. The first transaction, a cheque of 10,000 was deposited with the bank on 20th March 16, which is not yet recorded in the passbook. As you know that when you deposit the check and when it goes for the clearance, after getting it cleared, bank record in our bank account. So you have recorded in the cash book. So the entry in the cash book you have already done. I have prepared two. One is the cash book, one is the passbook. In the cash book, the first transaction, as you have deposited the check, 10,000 you have written on the debit side. So what is not done? I put the not done portion in the box. The not done is credit of 10,000 by the bank is not done. So our answer is the check deposited but not credited in the passbook. So first transaction, check deposited but not credited in passbook. Passbook. So not credited, so you credit. So 10,000 you have to credit. Whatever I write in the box, that effect is not done. So that will be our answer. Interest credited by bank 160 on 30th March 16, not recorded in the cash book. So bank has credited interest. This is our income. So when we have to increase our balance, we write in the debit side. Increase of the balance on the debit side, decrease of the bank balance on the credit side. Like that, in the passbook, the increase of balance credit and decrease of balance debit. So 160, you have to debit, which is not done. So I put into box. I put into box 160, that to be debited. So write down number 3, second transaction, interest not recorded in cash book, rupees 160. The next transaction, number 3, a customer has deposited 10,000 directly in the bank account. So customer has deposited. So with this, our bank balance has already increased, 10,000. Bank has credited, we have to debit. So 10,000 put into box, not done. So we are now going to do. Debit rupees 10,000. Transaction number 3. Okay. Directly deposited into bank. Customer directly deposited into bank. Number 4. The fourth transaction, check deposited with bank but not recorded in cash book. Deposited in bank. When you have deposited in bank, already that check is done by the bank with the 8,000 credit. So what we have not done? We have not recorded in the our cash book. So not recorded, so let us record. 8,000 debit. Check deposited in bank, not recorded in cash book. Means you have, without recording in the cash book, you have deposited into bank. Number 5. A check drawn and paid by the bank but not recorded in cash book. Drawn and paid. It means that bank has already decreased our balance with 6,000. So what is not done? Not done number 5, 6,000. We have forgot to write in the cash book. So we are going to credit 6,000 rupees. Number 5, that is check. Check you have drawn but not recorded in cash book. See, whatever is the reason, that you have to narrate in as short as possible. Number 6. Check a bills receivable of 3,000 discounted with the bank is dishonored and bank has recorded the amount in the passbook including noting charge which is not known to the Naresh. So we don't know. This transaction is done first by the bank. So we have to record transaction with both the amount, bill amount plus the noting charge. Bank has already decreased our balance with 3040. Bank has reduced our balance. So we have to credit that amount 3040. This is not done. So we need to do. Number 6. You have to credit 3040. Bill receivable dishonor. Not recorded in cash book. So the bill amount, that is 3,000 plus 40 noting charge. This is an extra charge which a bank has paid. So we have to record that 40 also. So 3040 total you are going to credit. Total of the receipt side of the cash book, short by, underlined word short. Receipt side. Receipt side is short. It means that short, if it is undercasted, give the same effect. If it is overcasted, give the opposite effect. Short means undercasted. So receipt side means the debit side. So debit side is undercasted with rupees 2,000. So you have to debit 2,000. Here nothing to deal with the passbook. Clear? So number 7. Cash book, receipt side, total short. Receipt side means, you know very well, means the debit side. So debit is short, so we have to debit that 2000 rupees. Check drawn but not presented for payment. You have returned the check. When you have returned the check you have credited rupees 1000. But this particular check not presented, it means that bank has not debited your 1000 check. So this we have to do here. Number 8, 1000 to be debit. See, whatever is not done, that is our answer. So check drawn but not presented. You can say presented for payment, or you can say in short that not yet debited in the passbook. Number next, check deposited but not credited in the bank. You have deposited the check. So when you deposit that check, you have debited. Amount is rupees 1500. So what you have debited, what is not done, that is not credited. How much? 1500. So this is our answer. We have to credit 1500. Check deposited but not credited in passbook. Okay, not credited, so you credit. Number 10. Bank has debited commission of 80 in the passbook. 80 rupees bank has debited, clear, in the passbook. So we need to credit. That credit work is not done in our cash book. So what is not done, that we have to do. We have to credit rupees 80. Clear? So bank commission not recorded in cash book. Other way round, bank commission is your expense. All expenses we used to credit in our cash book. So that to be done. After completing and giving the effect to all the transactions, either you credit, either you debit, or some transaction may come which you have no entry in the BRS. Later on, those transactions also will come. After completing all, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, all we have done. Now do the higher side total first. The total you have, that is 32,620. And you will find the difference, that is bank overdraft as per passbook. So the difference will come 11,460. This is what your difference. You have started with the cash book. So your answer is the passbook. Passbook, bank, overdraft. Okay, you don't have a balance, you have an overdraft of 11,460. In this manner, how to solve the BRS example? Once again, read the transaction, visualize two books, cash book, passbook. Whatever entry is given, give that entry. The not given entry, put it into box. Whatever you put into box, that is your BRS column. If it comes in debit, write in debit. If in credit, write in credit. After giving all the effects, do the total. Higher side total, right opposite side, find the difference. The difference will give you the answer. If you have started with the cash book, your answer going to be passbook. If you have started with the passbook, answer going to be cash book. And here, as per passbook, you have debit balance. It means that it is known as a bank overdraft. So this way the BRS example are to be done. Now you try yourself question number 4 of your textbook, page number 290. You will be able to solve on your own. Follow the same method and do question number 4 for practice. Thank you.